Hey dear children, welcome once again to Easy English Explanation by Pooja Joshi. This is the third part of 9th Standard NCERT book, The Lost Child, first chapter, Moments book. So let's see, and if you want to check the first and second part, then you can see the I button upside. So let's start. There was a roundabout in full swing. Men, women and children, carried away by in a whirling motion, shrieked and cried with dizzy laughter. The child watched them intently, and then he made a bold request. I want to go on the roundabout, please, father, mother. Now, what he saw after all this? He saw a roundabout. Roundabout means a swing, like merry-go-round, one ride of the fair. It's a very, very famous all-time old ride, that merry-go-round, roundabout, which goes on like this, in the fair. Men, women and children, they were shrieking, they were making shrill, very rough noises, and they were so happy and they were crying with laughter. And when they sat on the roundabout, the child watched them intently, very, very carefully the child watched them, and he asked his parents to let him sit. Now he made a bold request. Till now he was making request by murmuring, by slowly murmuring, but now he made a bold request. He was bold enough to say that whatever you must have denied me previously, or I would not have asked you, but now it's final that I want to go on this roundabout. Now not anymore I will heed you, I just want to sit on this. Okay, then there was no reply. He turned to look at his parents. They were not there. Ahead of him, he turned to look on either side. They were not there. He looked behind. There was no sign of them. There was no reply when he asked his parents to go on the roundabout. Then he turned one side to look for his parents. They were not there. Ahead of him, they were not there. Before him, then other side he looked, they were not there. He could not find his parents anywhere. There was no sign of them at all. A full deep cry rose within his throat, dry throat, and with a sudden jerk of his body, he ran from where he stood, crying in real fear, "Mother, father!" Tears rolled down from his eyes, hot and fierce. His flushed face was convulsed with fear. Panic-stricken, he ran to one side first and then to the other, hither and thither, in all directions, knowing not where to go. "Mother, father," he wailed. His yellow turban came untied and his clothes became muddy. Now, as he felt that his parents were not there with him, suddenly he felt that lost in the whole world. Now the child was lost, as the title, The Lost Child. So he could not find his parents anywhere. Suddenly he filled with fear. He was panic stricken. A full deep cry rose within his dry throat. He shouted and started crying a lot. And he had the sudden jerk. Jerk means shake of his body. And he started running to whichever direction he could. And now he was crying in real fear. "Mother, father," and tears rolled down his eyes like anything. The tears were hot. He was inside, he was very scared. So his face turned hot and fierce. And his flushed face, tears flushed his face. And he was convulsed. He was totally filled with fear. Convulsed. I'll give you the word meanings also at the end of videos in the videos I will give in the end, the glossary, the word meaning, so that you can again note down, children, and write it down in your notebooks as well as learn them, be ready with the new words. Panic stricken. He was afraid. He was struck with panic. He ran to one side first, then he again came back from other that side and went to the second side. Here and there, like northeast, southwest, he searched in all the directions, but he didn't know what to do exactly or where to go. Of course, he was a child of an old times, not here, right now of this times, otherwise the parents would have lost, not the child. Okay. Mother, father, he wailed. Wailed means he cried aloud. Wailed, yes. Then having his yellow turban also came untied, means yellow turban was not now tied to his head and it was coming out, and his clothes became muddy by running here and there. Having run to and fro in a rage of running for a while, he stood defeated, his cries suppressed into sobs. At little distances on the green grass, he could see through his filmy eyes men and women talking. He tried to look intently among the patches of bright yellow clothes, but there was no sign of his father and mother among these people who seemed to laugh and talk just for the sake of laughing and talking. Having run to and fro. Having run to and fro means here and there, he ran up and down in a rage. Rage means in anger, in a fit of running for a while. Now he was very tired of too much running and shouting and crying. Now his cries suppressed, they were lowered down, and now it turned into sobs, like that. Now he could not take out huge cries because he may be lack of energy. And at little distance he saw that on green grass men and women were talking. He tried to look intently, very very intently, word came previously also, very very carefully. He tried to look about his parents. He looked and searched for his parents. There were patches of bright yellow clothes. The people were in the fair, so they were wearing yellow clothes and they were wearing very bright clothes. But there was no sign of his father and mother among these people. He could not find his father. He could not find his mother. See, if we are very sad or depressed and lonely, then we feel about the whole world that why, if somebody, some group of people, when they are talking and laughing and enjoying themselves, then we will feel that why they are talking and enjoying and laughing themselves. Because we are sad, we don't like that others should laugh or talk nicely. He also felt the same thing, that these people are unnecessarily laughing or talking. They are just having fun. He ran quickly again, this time to a shrine to which people seemed to be crowding. Every little inch of space here was congested with men, but he ran through people's legs, his little sob lingering. Mother, father, near the entrance to the temple. However, the crowd became very thick. Men jostled each other, heavy men with flashing, murderous eyes and hefty shoulders. The poor child struggled to thrust a way between their feet, but knocked to and fro by their brutal movements, he might have been trampled underfoot had he not shrieked at the highest pitch of his voice, "Father, mother!" And a man in the surging crowd heard his cry and, stooping with great difficulty, lifted him up in his arms. So now what happened here? He ran quickly again, and this time he ran to a shrine. Shrine means a holy place, temple. And there people were crowding in the fair. And crowd was so much that it was congested. The space was not there. Person feel difficulty to breathe even in a congested place. Every inch of space was covered with people. He ran between people's legs to find out his parents. Now his little sob was lingering. Lingering means it still stayed. It still continued. And he was lingering for mother and father near the entrance to the temple. And the crowd became very thick. Men jostled. Men pushed each other. There were heavy men. Heavy, of course, and with comparison to the child. They were having the flashing or murderous eyes as if they will murder the child. They had big, hefty shoulders. The poor child struggled to thrust away. To thrust means to push through a way, to get a way. Like he just pushed, try to push through the way between their feet. But he was knocked down to and fro by their brutal movements. Brutal here, very brutal means very, very animal type or jungly movements. That is the very strong, rude movements. Wild movements. Brutal means wild, we can see. He might have been trampled. He might have been crushed under their foot. But he shrieked. Shriek means at the full voice he shouted with great difficulty at the highest pitch of his possible voice. Father, mother, then a person in the surging, in the upcoming, in the increasing crowd, surging, growing crowd, like here, increasing crowd, a person was able to hear and stooping with great difficulty. Stooping means turning low, down, turning down, moving down to pick that child up. He picked that child up with a very, very great difficulty. He lifted up the child in his own arms. Otherwise, the child would have been crushed under the, trampled under the feet of people. How did you get here, child? Whose baby are you? The man asked as he steered clear of the mass. He just made his way with the child. He cleared the way from the mass and brought child to a place where there were very less people or no people. The child wept more bitterly than ever now and only cried, "I want my mother, I want my father." As the man, that stranger, asked that, "Whose baby were you?" Then the man asked him that, "What about your parents? Whose baby are you?" He only sobbed to the, shouted to the top of his voice. He cried bitterly than ever, wept, cried aloud, "I want my mother, I want my father." He did nothing else. He didn't try to give any name or address, or maybe he was not able to tell, and he's so scared that he only shouted to find his father and mother. With this, we end the third part of The Lost Child. See you soon in the next part. But before that, saying bye-bye.